time with a bunch of people from the show, so I'm just learning about slots.
All right.
I take my money.
Out in nearby Las Vegas, in Reno, Nevada, JD is visiting with a super collector of the world's largest collection of antique slot machines. JD?
Hey, well, you guys have come to the right place to learn about slot machines. What do you do if you have, over 150 antique slot machines? Well, you open a restaurant, and that's exactly what Marshall Fay did. We're here at the Liberty Bell, and your grandfather is the reason you started collecting slot machines, right, Marshall?
Absolutely, J.D., yes.
Why is that?
Well, his machine is considered the most important machine in the industry.
And your grandfather
is the forerunner of over a million machines built just like it.
And your grandfather was Charles Fay.
Charles Fay, yeah.
And in 1899, he developed this machine, which appropriately is called the Liberty Bell, right?
That's right.
Huh. And how is this significant?
Well, it's because it is the first one.
And you said there were millions, there have been millions made since.
Just like it.
Now, you and your brother opened this restaurant in 58, and all the people can come in and they can see your incredible collection, right?
Well, we get people from all over the world come see our collection.
Now, does your grandfather's machine work?
Absolutely.
Give it her spin. Yeah. Let's see if we're going to get lucky.
It's a Fay machine.
It's a Fay machine.
Yeah,
it
guaranteed.
Works.
Now, watch.
Wow.
We almost had three Liberty Bells. That's the highest pay. That pays 20 coins.
All right, and we're going to check out more of Marshall's incredible slot machines when we come back, John.
All right, JD, looking forward to it. Thanks a lot.
All right.
The clock in that thing was interesting.
Well, let's go out to Nevada where JD is going to give us a sneak preview of today's super collection. JD, where are you right now?
John, I am up in the attic above the Liberty Bell restaurant, and this is where Marshall Fay stores a lot of his slot machines, and he has them up here for storage as well as maintenance, and he likes to come up here and play with them every now and then. Look at this one, John. This is an old slot machine from the 40s. It looks like a toaster, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But you open it up, and you've got a slot machine. Here we go. Let's see if we hit the jackpot.
Come on, JD.
Come on, cherries! Well, we hit the jackpot with a great collection, and we're going to see antique slot machines coming up next on Personal FX.
Grand cinnamon rolls from Pillsbury.
They're relish.
The most enormous, ooey, gooey, luscious.
Should we wake the others?
Not yet. The kids were up late.
Indulgent. Irresistible.
Well, what about Mr. H?
He should rest.
Completely decadent cinnamon rolls ever.
Hey, aren't your parents visiting?
Let them sleep.
Grands now have 20% more cinnamon, so...
They're not just big, they're grands.
Woo-hoo!
At a recent meeting of the Cookie Jar Investment Club...
This new Minute Maid Premium says it tastes like eating a fresh ripe orange.
Mmm. It tastes like something we should look into.
Paul Curl, tell him to gas up the jet.
When we finally got to check it out, the vote was unanimous.
Definite buy.
Bye.
Next up, the supermarket. We think this stuff's going to be big. We're not usually wrong about these things.
New Minute Maid Premium. Right into it. There are 3 million kids in this country who wet the bed, often for no other reason than their bladders haven't grown as quickly as the rest of their bodies. One product can help, that protects yet looks and feels like real underwear. Good nights mean good mornings. Hill Science Diet, the only pet food with advanced RDA system nutrition, so your dog will come alive with health. It gives dogs the perfect balance of vitamins and minerals for a healthy difference you can see. Guaranteed. In fact, Science Diet is the number one choice of veterinarians for their own pets. So ask your veterinarian about Hill Science Diet for a healthy difference you can see. Guaranteed.
On October 31st, prepare yourself for FX Extreme Halloween. Starting at 8.
Oh my God.
It's a howling hour of the X-Files. Then at 9, The Dead Are Restless and Starved for Blood in The Lost Boys.
She was fiend.
And at 11, The X-Files returns.
I'll be seeing you
with a bloodthirsty tale of horror. FX FX takes a bite out of Halloween. Friday starting at 8 on FX Extreme Halloween.
Did you know this is amazing? This is the first slot machines of the 1890s paid out in drinks and cigars rather than cash. The machine would print out award cards for your winnings, and you would take the cards to the attendant on the floor to redeem your jackpot. Your jackpot.
You know what I was picturing when you go to like Atlantic City and the slot machine, they have these big cups for all your quarters.
Right.
You know, you have to go with a drink. You know, like right. To pour out a drink.
Yeah, maybe a cigar comes shooting
right,
out of there.
Exactly.
You can do that. All right, let's take a look at some of these antique slot machines. They're really interesting,
right? Maybe JD will get lucky and win a little.
Yeah, JD, come on, you gotta get lucky before the show's over.
I know, man. I hope I can do better here than I've been doing in the casinos. We're back here with Marshall Fay, and this is his incredible collection of antique slot machines. Now, tell us about these. These are really interesting.
JD, this is a 1907 Cayley Twin Centaur. These are beautiful machines. They're quarter sewn oak. They're cast iron nickel plated.
Mm-hmm.
They're very desirable collectors. This machine today would sell for about $20,000.
Mm. Wow. Now, what's the object here?
Well, the idea here is you can play different bits. This is a quarter machine on the left and a nickel on the right.
Mm-hmm.
You could place a bet seven different slots. You have six different bets. If you wanted to bet the red, you'd push this button down here,
and
the reel would spin
red
around.
Yeah,
there's a lot of reds and a lot of blacks.
Now, we have this one, and this is a single, right?
This is a single.
And play that. Let's see if
we
can play
it.
Yeah,
we're going to get a winner.
Okay,
we're going to play the what?
Okay. This is Claire's nickel.
Okay.
Come
down.
Good luck.
Push the handle down, round the wheel goes.
And you want to go black, right?
Red.
Huh? It was red.
Right next to it.
No, it's always right next
very
to it. What is
yeah.
the deal with
hey,
these?
It's always a winner.
Now, tell us about these. These are interesting
now,
because
this,
if you notice, there's gum next to the slot machines. What's the significance
okay,
of that?
Okay, first we'll start with Liberty Bell. This evolved from our grandfather's machine.
Mm-hmm.
They stole his machine, Bill's Novelty in Chicago. He used the same name. But there always was problems with the law. So in 1910, they put a gum vendor on the side, then they could call it a vending machine.
Right, because you weren't allowed to gamble, and you couldn't get a payout.
Maybe you actually were gambling. You put your money in here,
uh-huh.
and your money come out here, but the gum was optional, so you're always getting something for your nickel. Now, the symbols evolved from these gum flavors. You have the plum gum, cherry gum, orange gum, lemon gum. The bar, there's no jackpot. That's the gum wrapper label. And the highest pay on these machines was 20 coins.
Claire, you were talking about the big cups that people would
yes.
use. Well, this is an old token holder, right?
1908 token holder.
Wow.
It was made for a San Francisco novelty company. And trade checks was another way they got around the law.
Mm-hmm.
These have a little hole in them. So they would not be like a nickel. And you have a feeler pin in your machine. When you pull the handle down, the feeler pin would go through the hole, allow the check to go into the payout chute.
Right.
If you had a nickel in there, the feeler pin would push forward and knock the nickel into the cash can.
It would reject it. As you can see, we have more gum machines down here.
You couldn't give a package of gum for a nickel, so you give a gum ball on the penny machine.
Now tell us about this one right here.
During the 30s, the slot machines were at their maximum sales.
Mm-hmm.
During the height of the Depression, and when the Depression was at its worst, slot machine sales were at its best. And these machines are very beautiful. Early machines were more or less of Victorian nature. But this one here, in 1931, they came out with a new series. It's the Mills Silent Bell.
Mm-hmm.
This is a 1937 Cherry Bell, and it has fortune-telling reels, another way to make the machine more interesting. And if you look up on here, these are all machines built by Mills Novelty Company from 1931 all the way up to 1946.
And if you notice how colorful and how decorative
yeah.
they are, that was something that they did to draw people into the casinos, right?
Yeah.
Through the machines.
Well, you think of casinos. Actually, slot machines were in single locations.
Mm-hmm.
There weren't casinos, per se, until 1931.
Let's hit the Cherry Bell. Let's see how we do here.
Go for it.
Okay, let me put this in. This one will do for John.
All right,
and pull it down. Let's see. Cherries. Man. Not getting lucky today.
You got a winner.
Okay,
hey.
You got three.
All right, John. We got three that are coming to you. 15 cents.
Okay.
Now tell us about this one. Look at this machine, John and Claire.
We're going back a lot of years now. This is right after the turn of the century, and this is the epitome of the poker machines. Poker
mm-hmm.
machines were extremely popular. On this machine here, you can play five different hands. You had five different windows, five slots down here. Now, we played number three, which would be this window here.
Okay, this is the window we have to watch.
Down. The wheels are all going in opposite directions. The highest pay on this machine is 50 cigars. Cigars, like the candy, was a way to get you on the wall. You wouldn't want to take the 50 cigars. So you came up, bartender said, give me
the cash value.
I want the money.
Wow. Now, tell us about this guy over here. This is an interesting one, and we've seen a lot of these in casinos, and you say that there are reproductions, but this is the original,
this
right?
is the original, done by Frank Polk. There's 99 of these machines. Frank Polk is in the Artist Hall of Fame. He's mm-hmm. a very noted cowboy artist. But he cut these all out of wood. They used a standard slot machine in here. Today, these machines will bring between $12,000 and $15,000.
Wow! Now, look behind him, because we have to show this one. Tell us about this. This is the... the creme de la creme, isn't it?
There are a lot of very valuable machines.
Mm-hmm.
I told you our grandfather's machine went for $143,000. That's the highest. Now, this machine would probably be just about next. This would sell for $45,000. And there's a lot of people who would like to buy them. They're
wow.
very rare.
How much did
but
you pay
the design
for?
Is so great. Well, we paid $100. Well, we were broke then. That $100 was about
$45,000. Okay, does this one work?
Oh, absolutely. We play this, put a nickel in here. We're going for the $2. That's the red one.
Okay.
You got to wind her up.
This one's for you, JD.
Spinning around.
This one's for you, JD.
And if we land
it's
in,
what?
It's for you.
All right. Oh, we didn't get it. It was right next to it, though, because that's always the way, isn't it?
Yeah, that certainly is, J.D.
Well, Marshall, thank you so much for being such a slot machine historian.
Oh, real pleasure to have you here at the Liberty Bell.
Telling us about the history of the slot machine.
They are beautiful. I don't think they make them as exquisitely designed today as they used to.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
Boy, we enjoyed that a ton. Thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Wasn't that great?
They're works of art when you look at the fine details of them.
All those colors and stuff. Man, there's something.